Reasons why everyone is in love with Japan. Are you a fan of anime, Sakura, Sumo, Japanese noodles, and even breathtaking sights? Well, Japan is the answer for your fantasies turned into reality. In this video, I will be sharing with you the reasons why everyone is in love with Japan. So, make sure to stay tuned all the way so you won't miss your chance to explore Japan at its finest. Welcome to our channel, Travel 195, where you can travel virtually while we're taking you to different places around the world. Make sure to click that subscribe button, ring that notification bell, hit like, and share this video with your travel buddies. Let's get started. The most incredible travel destination in the world, Japan, provides several one-of-a-kind experiences that are unavailable anywhere else. This nation's culture is an intriguing fusion of Western modernism with Eastern traditions, which is evident everywhere. One of the oldest civilizations, Japan has a stunning and varied past. The gorgeous, diverse landscapes, which the Japanese love for its mountains and breathtaking views, offers so many diverse experiences that draws travelers from all over the world. In this video, we share our top justifications for visiting this incredible nation at least once in your lifetime, and why those who visit fall deeply in love with Japan. Number 1. Pristine natural scenery. The first factor is undoubtedly the nation's breathtaking natural splendor. Japan is a nature lover's heaven in many aspects, despite the fact that many people conceive of it as a very modern nation with dazzling neon lights, cutting-edge technology, shopping malls, and high-end stores. The country is home to some of the nicest natural scenery in the world once you venture outside of the large, contemporary cities. Japan's natural landscape is tremendously diversified, ranging from the untamed terrain of Hokkaido to the immaculately white beaches of Okinawa. Natural beauty may be enjoyed all year long and includes rough mountains, rocky coasts, immaculate white beaches, bamboo forests, and some of the world's most stunning waterfalls. Number 2. The breathtaking Mount Fuji. Everywhere in the world, Mount Fuji is well known as a destination to visit at any time of year. But because it holds a very special, hallowed place in Japanese culture, the majestic Fuji-san is more than simply a mountain. It has been a sacred location for Shintoism, the native religion of Japan since the 7th century. Japanese people have long had a special connection to Mount Fuji, which is why it can be seen in numerous works of art such as pottery, calligraphy, ukiyo-e paintings, and woodblock prints. Many people place climbing Mount Fuji at the top of their bucket lists, and an estimated 400,000 people do so annually. The peak's 3,776 meters climbing season lasts from the beginning of July to the beginning of September. However, Mount Fuji is a sight to behold even if you have no interest in climbing to the top. Number 3. Incredible cuisine. Despite the fact that Japanese food is available throughout the world, the nation draws millions of travelers every year only to sample real Japanese cuisine. Try some fresh sushi at Tsukiji Fish Market or some delectable street food like takoyaki in Osaka. Sushi conveyor belts and sake bars are other common experiences. For many tourists, traveling to Japan gives them the chance to indulge in some real kaiseki cuisine. Kaiseki is a traditional style of cooking that originated in Japan over a period of thousands of years and uses ingredients that are uncommon elsewhere in the globe. The best sushi, ramen, and tempura can be found in any unassuming city establishment. Even the cuisine served at konbini is delectable and consistently freshly prepared. Tokyo is the city with the most Michelin stars worldwide and also has the most 3-star restaurants. You have a once-in-a-lifetime experience waiting for you when you combine it with a range of traditional Japanese drinks. Number 4. Magnificent temples, shrines, and Zen gardens. In Japan, there are thought to be 80,000 temples and shrines of varying sizes, some of which are more than 1,000 years old. When you visit Buddhist temples and Zen gardens, you can literally sense how tranquil and enchanting these settings are because they are so breathtaking. The most well-known Shinto shrines in Japan are called O-Inari-san and are called Inari Shrines. There are thousands of them scattered across the nation. The Fushimi Inari Shrine in Kyoto, which honors Inari, the Shinto god of rice, is one of the most significant Inari shrines. It is renowned for having a large number of vermilion torii gates and is undoubtedly something you should see for yourself. You can visit shrines all across the country, including in the heart of Tokyo that contains rows of torii gates, even if Kyoto is not on your itinerary. Number 5. Friendly people. It won't take you long to realize that Japanese behavior is entirely different from that of people in Western nations when you visit Japan. Japanese individuals strive to cause as little disruption to those around them as possible. It is so quiet inside the train that you will immediately sense it when you get there. Everyone is really helpful and as respectful as they can be. You can always find someone to help you out if you have a question or seem to be confused about something. Even though the language barrier can be challenging at times, Japanese people are always willing to assist you. A feeling like this is challenging to express in words, so you should definitely have this experience for yourself. Number 6. For safety. Japan has one of the lowest crime rates in the entire globe, making it one of the safest nations. It seems to make sense that the Japanese are quite proud of this. Japanese residents frequently leave their doors unlocked. Kids are completely secure riding the subway by themselves, and tourists can feel at ease walking through the cities at night. Japanese culture values the common good above individual demands, which contributes to the country's low crime rate. You may encounter certain circumstances that seems risky or like idiotic behavior to you but are entirely acceptable in Japan. In Tokyo, the largest city in the world, you can fall asleep on the train and yet wake up with your wallet and phone in hand because Japan is so safe. You may even witness some salaryman sprawled out on the street after having one or two too many drinks, yet their valuables won't be taken from them. Always make an effort to find anything you left behind in a restaurant or on a train, since it's very probable that someone saved it for you or gave it to the police. Number 7. Efficient public transportation. Japan's public transportation system is out of this world. The system is simply amazing, especially in the larger cities. It is surprising how quickly you can go from one part of the city to another within a short amount of time when trains or metros depart every few minutes during the day. You can travel anywhere in the nation on the renowned Shinkansen, popularly referred to as the bullet train. With numerous departures throughout the day, Japan's huge high-speed train network, which connects Hokkaido, Honshu, and Kyushu, is incredibly dependable. With 370 departures each day, the Tokaido Shinkansen line, which connects Tokyo, Osaka, and Kyoto, is the busiest and most well-liked railway in Japan. It is unquestionably the easiest, most dependable, and fastest option for visitors to learn about Japan. The best aspect for foreign visitors is that they may buy a Japan Rail Pass, which will grant them unrestricted travel across the entire nation for a predetermined amount of time. Number 8. Remarkable experience. Despite the fact that adventure tourism is not typically associated with Japan, this country offers a wide variety of thrilling activities. The alternatives for thrill seekers are endless. From snowboarding or skiing in Hokkaido or Nagano, to cycling along the Seto Inland Sea, gaining a glimpse of Mount Fuji from the roller coasters of Fuji Q Highlands, or sandboarding in Tottori, Japan's desert. Since roughly 75% of Japan is covered in hilly terrain, you may go on some incredible multi-day hikes or follow in the footsteps of old pilgrimage routes like the Shikoku 88 Temples Pilgrimage or the Kumano Kodo Trail to experience the ideal fusion of nature and culture. In addition, you can actively explore the neighborhood while riding a traditional Japanese rickshaw at numerous popular tourist destinations like Arashiyama or Asakusa. Number 9. Festivals and Matsuri. Japan offers a variety of events and Matsuri for visitors to enjoy throughout the year. During Matsuri, a traditional Japanese festival, Floats known as mikoshi are frequently transported between temples and shrines. They frequently take place in the summer and draw tens of thousands or even millions of visitors thanks to their vibrant atmosphere and fun activities for all ages. You can also find several wonderful and distinctive celebrations during the winter, such as the nationwide Kamakura Snow Hut Festivals. There are also a number of illumination festivals, some of which only endure over the Christmas season, while others go well into the spring with magnificent light displays and decorations. Sapporo's Snow Festival, another well-known event, draws many tourists each year with its magnificent ice sculptures and inviting winter settings. Number 10. Clean and Green. After arriving, you'll quickly realize that Japan is extraordinarily clean. Even in Tokyo, a major metropolis, the streets are generally clean, and there is rarely litter lying around or cigarette butts on the curbs. You might be wondering how this is even possible given the scarcity of trash cans in urban areas. The solution is straightforward. Japanese people respect their environment, pick up after themselves, and bring their waste home. Motainai, which roughly translates to nothing goes to waste, is a cultural ideal widely regarded in Japanese society. When something breaks, it is frequently mended and reused rather than promptly replaced. Number 11. Shopper's Paradise. Another good incentive to travel to Japan is to shop. Though more for domestic than for foreign products, Tokyo and other major cities are home to first-rate shopping malls as well as traditional marketplaces where you may buy crafts and souvenirs made in the area. Cities of all sizes frequently have their own particular shopping district. A shotengai is a street lined with tiny shops and neighborhood merchants. If you're visiting Tokyo, you should go to Akihabara, Venus Fort, and Harajuku, which are all very popular neighborhoods. Omeda and Shinsaibachi are two additional well-liked shopping areas in Osaka. Shopping in Tokyo will be a memorable experience for fans of video games and anime. Nakano is the perfect place to go. Number 12. Weird but Techy Stuff. Japan is home to a wide variety of unusual items like square watermelons, washing toilets that blow dry and play music, plastic meal menus, cartoon versions and mascots of everything, maid cafes, and more. To experience the well-known Japanese kawaii culture, simply stroll around Harajuku. The cuteness in Japan knows no bounds. Cute girls, cute food, and cute mascots. For example, Japan's otaku or geek culture is another distinctive popular culture. An otaku is a person who enjoys manga or anime to an extreme. Tokyo's Akihabara and Nakano are the best venues to experience some of the otaku cultures of Japan. Number 13. The Blooming of Sakura. Without Sakura, a trip to Japan in the spring is incomplete. Everyone and everything lived in the spirit of the lovely flowers for 2 weeks. Hanami, blossom-watching parties, are commonplace since everyone wants to witness this million-dollar view. Japan has a strong affinity for picnics among cherry trees that are in full bloom. Sakura represents the coming of spring, a season of rebirth and hope. And because the cherry blossoms only bloom for a brief period of time, about 2 weeks, they also represent the transience of life, a central idea in Buddhism. You can get limited edition Sakura-flavored snacks and mementos everywhere during the cherry blossom season. Number 14. The Famous Ghibli. The Ghibli films have made a significant contribution to Japan's well-known anime culture. Have you ever seen Spirited Away or My Neighbor Totoro? They are some of the most well-known anime films ever made and were created by Hayao Miyazaki's famed Studio Ghibli, a company known for its animation and fine art. You can see sketches for Studio Ghibli films, models for how cartoons are created, and a special short film at the Ghibli Museum in Tokyo. A must-see if you love Ghibli films. Visit some of the sites that were utilized in Ghibli films if you want something more. Number 15. Onsen and Sento. Onsen is frequently mentioned as one of the top things that people love about Japan when asked. As it differs greatly from taking a bath in other nations across the world, visiting an onsen, a hot spring filled with mineral-rich spring water, heated by geothermal forces, and containing many minerals beneficial to the body, is a must-try experience for travelers. It is a significant component of Japanese culture and the best way to unwind after a day spent exploring Japan's natural beauty and rich culture. When taking an onsen, a tradition that dates back to at least the 8th century, there are a number of written and unwritten norms to abide by. Kisatsu Onsen, Hakone Onsen, and Beppu Onsen are well-known onsen resorts. Sento is a public bathhouse where visitors must pay a fee to enter. These bathrooms, which could be found in both large towns and tiny villages, were typically used by households without their own bath. As more homes with bathing facilities are built today, the number of sento is declining. Number 16. UNESCO World Heritage Site. You should be aware by now that Japan has a lengthy history, a rich culture, and some of the most stunning locations on Earth. In fact, Japan is home to no less than 23 UNESCO World Heritage Sites, 19 of which are cultural and 4 of which are natural, including places like Mount Fuji or Shiretoko National Park, as well as historically significant sites like Itsukushima Shinto Shrine or Miyajima. Number 17. Japanese Castles. Many castles were created throughout Japan's history, but many of them were destroyed by numerous battles or natural calamities like earthquakes. However, there are still some stunning castles in Japan that are open for tours, and some of which are listed as UNESCO sites. There are a total of 12 original castles spread out over the nation, each of which has a castle tower that was constructed in Edo or earlier. Number 18. Sumo and Sports Events. The Grand Sumo Tournaments, which take place every other odd-numbered month and lasts for 2 weeks, are another form of distinctive cultural events. The national sport of Japan is sumo, which is also a martial art. Sumo matches with a guide can help you better comprehend this ancient sport because sumo is actually filled with Shinto ceremonies. You should definitely try watching a sumo match at least once in your life. The most popular sport in Japan is baseball, which was first played there in 1872 by an American college professor. Anybody will find watching a baseball game exciting, regardless of whether they are a fan or not. Joining Japanese baseball fans and supporting their clubs is enjoyable. The games often begin at 2 p.m. or 6 p.m. and lasts for 3.5 hours. Number 19. Traditional Art and Craft. Craft has a long history in Japan and has been significant to its culture. There is a long variety of traditional Japanese crafts, ranging from the more well-known ones like knives, pottery, kimonos, yukata, and tatami, to the less well-known ones like fukeshi dolls, fireworks, kendama, origami, daruma dolls, woodblock prints, nambu ironware, and spherical and folding fans. There are unique regional specialties in each area. Because they are crafted by skilled artisans, some of the crafts and art are more expensive, but they are all wonderful gifts to bring home. Numerous locations provide craft and art experiences such as pottery classes and tea ceremonies. Number 20. Unique Accommodation. Although there are many hotels in Japan that are Western style, you should also consider staying at a traditional Japanese ryokan. A ryokan is a traditional Japanese inn that dates back to the 8th century. It frequently has public spaces with tatami-floored rooms, onsens, and other venues where people can dress casually in yukata. A typical overnight stay includes a filling, substantial Japanese supper and breakfast created using locally sourced in-season ingredients. A ryokan is an excellent place to experience some of the traditional aspects of Japanese culture and enjoy onsen privately. Shukubo or temple lodging is a great choice if you want to learn about the straightforward and conventional way of life of Buddhist monks. Shukubo, is which literally translates to sleeping with the monks, offers more than just a restful night's sleep and delectable shojin ryori, a vegan Buddhist meal. You can also participate in the monks' morning prayers. Capsule hotels first appeared in Osaka and have since spread throughout Japan. These hotels, which are typically found in major cities, were initially marketed to people looking for a more affordable option for a single night stay. Recently, there have also been more opulent, though not particularly inexpensive, alternatives to the pod hotel that are more comfortable. As a takeaway, there are countless reasons to visit and love Japan, but these are just 20. I haven't even touched on the stunning autumnal hues, the adorable deer, animal cafes, or other topics like love hotels. There is no other country like Japan, with its singular fusion of ancient customs and contemporary rituals, century-old structures and serene gardens tucked amongst the city's modern skyscrapers. You can get amazing fresh cuisine, domestic beverages, sake, and regional delicacies from any greasy spoon restaurant. Friendly individuals who will go over and above to ensure your comfort and only ask for a simple thank you, dependable and prompt public transit in one of the world's safest countries. There are countless reasons for you to visit and to be deeply in love with Japan. Start making travel plans to Japan right away, and I'm sure you won't regret it. So that wraps up our list of the reasons why everyone is in love with Japan. So, are you deeply in love with Japan? What are you waiting for? Visit Japan now and experience the best feeling ever. Happy traveling! Don't forget to click that subscribe button, ring that notification bell, hit like, and share this video with your travel buddies. Till next time, sayonara!